Naval Warfare is a Roblox game where you can pick to be on Japan's side or USA's side. To win, you must destroy the other country's harbor, in which you can help doing that by capturing islands closer and closer to their harbor. In this video, I'm gonna explain the Roblox Naval Warfare Iceberg. Layer 1. Naval Warfare is based off the Battle of Midway. The Battle of Midway was a battle against Japan and US in World War II. Naval Warfare is based off from it, and the reason why that is because the game has carriers, destroyers, aircraft, and islands. I'm pretty sure destroyers weren't in the Midway battle, but they did get destroyed by Japan aircraft months before the battle has started. It can't be a coincidence that it's Japan versus US. Naval Warfare takes place in 1942. The Battle of Midway takes place in 1942, meaning that Naval Warfare also takes place in 1942. Naval Warfare Remastered. This refers to a game called Naval Warfare Remastered. It has been in development for 2 years, and it still is. For these 2 years, only testers can play the game. Layer 2. Legion of Jutland / Jutland Geneva Strike Force. Legion of Jutland, also called Jutland Geneva Strike Force, is a well-known naval warfare fiction. It was founded in May 20, 2020. They started as Jutland Geneva Strike Force, but they are now called Legion of Jutland. They made their way past many naval warfare fictions, becoming well-known. Jutland was and still is founded by Chinese Democracy. United Eurasian Strike Force. United Eurasian Strike Force is a naval warfare fiction founded on February 24, 2021. Their way of recruiting members is that they pay their staff Robux, which of course gets a lot of people interested. They have lost one war and won one war, but we'll get into that later in the iceberg. It was founded by Lamer 2, Zeroth Battalion. Zeroth Battalion, also called Zeroth Armada, is a naval warfare fiction founded by Epsilon. World Record. This refers to the naval warfare world record to win as fast as possible. A new world record has been recently accomplished by Zeroth Armada of finishing the game at 97 minutes and 13 seconds. Plane Rush. Plane Rush is a tactic in which everyone gets on a bomber, head straight to harbor while trying not to get shot at and defending if they must. Then after bombing the harbor, you land on the straight white line at the harbor for ships, and people with the RPG game pass will shoot the harbor until they win. People with the default gun shoot the enemies. Layer 3. The Oceanian Empire. The Oceanian Empire is a naval warfare fiction founded on May 18, 2021 by Plane. We'll get more into it later in the iceberg. Pacific Fleet. Pacific Fleet is a naval warfare fiction that helped the Oceanian Empire win against US in a war. Red Ravens. Red Ravens was a small group that once raided Jutland. War was declared in Jutland 1 and got Robux as part of the treaty from Red Ravens. Carrier Protection. Carrier Protection is a tactic. One or two carriers side to side, and when ready they charge to the harbor. No stopping at all. Planes should be attacking or protecting. No enemy planes or ships should get near the carrier. Piracy. Piracy is a tactic where everyone gets in a small plane and fly to the nearest ship and kill the crew. Double flank / triple flank. Double flank / triple flank is a tactic. If you have two ships, then each one goes around the sides. If it's three ships, then do the same thing but one goes through the middle. Same thing if you have multiple ships. Each side can have a varying amount of ships. Layer 4. Two-way squads. Two-way squads is a tactic. Assuming you are on Japan, from harbor one squadron of planes head for A in normal bombers, while the second squadron heads for harbor in heavy bombers. Double / triple carrier flank. DT carrier flank is a tactic. You take two or three carriers and make them use the double or triple flank. Then quickly assign specific people to each carrier. For double flank, half of the host will get on one carrier with planes, and triple flank, one-third of the host will get on one carrier with planes. Planes must protect the carrier using normal bombers, and when ships reach parallel to the enemy's main island, everyone gets in a heavy bomber and the carrier launches all the heavy bombers to the harbor. Harbor Swarm. Harbor Swarm is a tactic. Spawn at harbor with a large bomber. Immediately go to sea or a whatever is the closest island to harbor, and wait for everyone else. Once you get there on command, go exactly up until your fuel hits 85. So you use 15 fuel when going up, exactly go straight towards the enemy harbor and bomb it once you hit 85. If the 12 planes somehow don't destroy the base, the ones with RPG stay behind and continue to shoot the base. Carrier Strike Group. Carrier Strike Group is a tactic. For this you need one or two carriers, two or three heavy cruisers and one battleship. The heavy cruisers form a wedge on the battleship. If there are three heavy cruisers, then the battleship is in front of the heavy cruiser in the middle. If there are two heavy cruisers, then the battleship is simply between the two heavy cruisers. Island hop. Island hop is a tactic. Basically swarm all the islands with normal bombers, not heavy bombers. If you die and you have A or C, the enemy's main island, spawn a heavy bomber and bomb harbor. Full fleet. Full fleet is a base tactic with multiple sub-tactics. In full fleet, the host leader can say full fleet destroyer, sub-tactic, and you spawn in a destroyer. This goes for every other ship. If you are lagging too hard, jump on someone's ship. If it's full fleet battleships where everyone spawns in battleships and you don't have the game pass, spawn on a battleship with one of the members, once spawned and wait for host leader's orders. Island hop with free ship rush. Everyone will spawn on the carrier and battleship and get on the weapons. The people not on the weapons or driver will get in a bomber. The two ships charges the enemy harbor while planes do a island hop. Bomber escort. Half the team gets in a heavy bomber while the other half gets in a normal one. Bombers do the exact same thing in harbor swarm, but the escorts go 8 fuel up. Escorts make sure they're watching for any attackers, as their job is to protect the bombers, not go the same height and bomb with them. Layer 5, Jutland War against Cygnus Fleet. Cygnus Fleet was a naval warfare fiction created by Zeroth Armada staff, who were doing this behind the admiral's back. Cygnus went to war with Jutland and won. Zeroth Armada was then blamed for being involved with Cygnus, but that was false, as the admiral of Zeroth did not know that his staff were ruling Cygnus. But what's also interesting is that Cygnus split Jutland Geneva Strike Force into Legion of Jutland and United Eruzian Strike Force, which I will get into later. The Tankfish War. Tankfish is a Roblox YouTuber. He had posted a video about naval warfare, and some people began promoting Naval Warfare Remastered in his comment section. Chinese Democracy also called Donald, talked with Tankfish's event organizer staff and asked if they would like to do an event with Jutland and Zeroth. They agreed and a date was set. Jutland never made it in the game, but Zeroth won despite the massive amounts of lag. The event was streamed on Twitch. Technically this was still a war, as it was a battle between two groups, except it was for promotion and Zeroth profited from it. Zeroth Armada is a benevolent totalitarianism. Epsilon, the admiral of Zeroth Armada, has said that it is benevolent totalitarianism, meaning that he as an authoritarian leader exercises political power while benefiting the population. Oceania started as Prakrit forces. Before Oceania switched to naval warfare, they were Prakrit forces in 2017 at Electric State Dark Roleplay. Layer 6, Cygnus Fleet was a separate group operation that consisted of ZA staff members. I already explained this. Basically Zeroth Armada staff created Cygnus Fleet under the admiral's back. I don't have the information on why they did it. United Eruzian Strike Force was created during the Cygnus Fleet War. After Jutland Geneva Strike Force lost the war with Cygnus Fleet, Donald, the owner of Jutland, resigned and gave owner to Lamer 1. After he did that, Lamer 1 banned him from his own server and deleted the server. Donald remade the server and Lamer 1 created United Eruzian Strike Force. And in the remade server, Jutland Geneva Strike Force changed its name to Legion of Jutland. Oceania is pseudo country based off the book 1984. Oceanian is a fake country based off the book 1984 by George Orwell. And that is the end of the iceberg. That's all for today's iceberg. Goodbye.